Everything I do in these videos is purely for experimenting with documentary style content and should not be repeated at home. Hey everyone, Timon speaking. I have a normal laser just like this one. It shines pretty bright and reaches very far, but it's basically an ordinary laser pointer, suitable for pointing at objects on a whiteboard or playing with your cat, for example. This laser beam here is quite weak. I don't even feel it on my skin. But there are much more powerful lasers out there, and I managed to buy one. And it's in this case right here. So let's take a closer look. Here it is, the laser itself. Look at the aluminum casing. These are the things that cool it down so it doesn't get too hot. This is actually the laser itself. And look, it's powered by these batteries, and they are kept separate because if they touch during transport, it burns through the case and catches fire. Can you imagine? Well, this is the button that turns it on. There should actually be some kind of safety switch, but of course, the Chinese don't pay attention to any safety measures. It also comes with safety glasses, because if you use the laser without glasses and the beam hits your eyes, you'll go blind. It's very dangerous. Additionally, there's a battery charger for the battery and the accessories here. Well, let's try to turn it on for a second. Oh, wow! I turned it off because it could burn this thing. So, now let's see how it works. Let's start by seeing if our laser can light a match. Let's take three matches and place them in this box. Three next to each other, like this. Let's place them 30 centimeters away, put on the glasses, and turn on the laser. Aim gently at the sulfur and... oh, wow! It lights up! Second... and third... did you see that? All three matches lit up. And look, even the box is burning through. Great. Okay, that was close. But what if we put the match 1 meter away? Would the laser have enough power to light it? Let's find out. So, we turn on the laser, aim, and somehow we have hit the sulfur and make it light up. Okay, no worries. It won't work, right? Oh, wow! It's lit up! Look, it works! Oh, look, I think I burned the polystyrene foam behind it. Wow, polystyrene foam, by the way. Let's go look for the polystyrene foam. Okay. Whoa! Look how interesting it burns through. It's like an incinerator. It's like, you know, a magnifying glass in the sun. And listen, what an interesting sound. Yes, that's great. Write in the comments if you are enjoying the video so far. Well, anyway, you get the idea. I need to get likes for this cool laser quickly. And then I tried to light a cigarette. And wow, I did it. It lit up, but let me tell you, I personally don't smoke. And I don't advise it because it's very, very harmful. I bought a pack for a video once and have been using these cigarettes from time to time since then in experiments. But really, all you have to do with cigarettes is throw them away. And then I wondered if it was possible to light a Bengal fire with our laser. Okay, it doesn't work. Probably because my hand is shaking and the laser has to be steady. I put the laser in a holder like this and precisely aim the beam at our Bengal fire. But a minute passed and nothing happened. Unfortunately, for some reason, the laser didn't light the Bengal fire. Why do you think that is? Write in the comments. But our laser, on the other hand, can handle a balloon very well. And also, this laser can easily light the Bengala. But don't worry, it won't explode because it's not loaded. I wonder if this super powerful laser could melt gallium. I have this piece of gallium right here. By the way, look at how interesting it has solidified into crystals. Neat, right? We'll put it in a bowl and pour boiling water from the kettle over it. Actually, gallium starts to melt at 35 degrees, but it will melt much faster in boiling water. Now, this liquid metal can be easily extracted with a syringe. Gallium is an amazing metal. Holding molten metal in your hands is a very unusual sensation. It's like having a piece of Terminator right in my hand, right? I have this silicone mold with Lego people in it. And I want to make a Lego man out of gallium and then try to melt them with a high-powered laser. My gallium was enough for exactly 3 people. So, that the gallium solidifies faster, I'll put it in the refrigerator. So, our gallium has solidified, the figures are solid now, and let's take them out and look at them. By the way, look, gallium expands when it solidifies, it spills out of the figures. It reminds me of water, how ice expands when it solidifies. So, let's try to get a piece. Oh, wow, cool. Look how cool it is. All right, let's go for the other one. Wow, look at that clarity. You know, gallium in its liquid state reminds me of mercury. And in its solidified state, it looks like silver. It's like pure silver. I'm amazed. Look at the interesting shapes. Wow. Wow, guys, look at this. It's really cool. I don't have any more gallium. Otherwise, I could make a whole army of these gallium people. They're like little Terminators, aren't they? Very cool. I didn't expect them to be this cool. They even look like some kind of space aliens, right? And the laser would be perfect. So, super powerful laser versus gallium Lego man. Who's going to win? Let's turn it on. Wow, wow! The laser beam even changed color. It's sort of purple. It's impossible to look at directly. I'm wearing protective glasses, but it's very bright. It's like a welding machine. And look, I think the gallium is starting to melt. Wow, look, it's like the man has a Bigfoot. Yes, the laser beat the gallium. And what an incredible metal it is after all. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, don't forget to leave a comment and give it a thumbs up because I put a lot of effort into it. And goodbye, everyone. See you soon.